volts, amp hours, and watt hours. There's a lot of jargon thrown around when you're shopping for a battery. You've probably seen a power tool or a battery pack that's advertised with something like 6 amp hours or 9 amp hours. And with the way that it's marketed, you would automatically think, well, more amp hours must mean more power and more runtime and just overall a bigger battery. But that's not the full story. In fact, amp hours, which is commonly seen as AH, can really be misleading if you don't take into context the voltage as well. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. As you guys know, we don't only exist to give you honest feedback on products and save you money where we can. We also want to just make it simple for you so you can gain energy independence without needing an electrical degree. If you guys want to support us, you can subscribe down below for free. You can watch some of our other videos that we have to help you learn and check out some of our reviews when it comes time for you to get into portable power or solar. Okay. Let's start with the basics. Amp hours is a measurement of charge capacity. It's telling you how many amps a battery can deliver steadily over 1 hour. So theoretically, a 2 amp hour battery could deliver 2 amps over the period of 1 hour, or 1 amp for 2 hours. It's basically the size of the gas tank and current flow, not the total energy. But here's the catch. Amp hours don't account for the voltage. And voltage matters a lot. It matters because energy is a combination of current and the voltage. And that's where watt hours come in. Watt hours measures the actual stored energy in the battery. And the math is really simple. Watt hours equals amp hours times voltage. So if you were to, let's say, double the voltage while keeping the amp hours the exact same, you double the energy. And if you just look at the amp hours without looking at the voltage, you might think that you're getting a larger battery when you're really not. So this is something where you kind of need to be a little bit careful and take notice that companies can play a little bit of a marketing trick. They will advertise a battery as having, let's say, 6 amp hours, and some people without looking at the voltage would assume that that is larger than a 4 amp hour battery. And to make it clear, we're going to use a power tool example because different power tools usually use different voltage. Thankfully, solar is a little bit more standardized than power tools. We'll get to that in a little bit. But if you've noticed when you're shopping for a battery, the amp hours is usually in massive bold print and the voltage is usually in tiny print. Let's say that you're hanging out with a friend and you're helping them with a DIY project. You have your set of power tools, they have theirs, and you look down at your battery and you notice that yours says 4 amp hours. You look at theirs and theirs says 5. You might think right away they have a larger battery pack. But if you take into account the voltage of the tools, they're using a 12 volt system and you're using a 20 volt system. So if you add up the volts and the amp hours, you actually have a larger battery at 80 watt hours and theirs is 60. Now, obviously you should also just be taking into account what the power demand is on the end of the tool. And once you figure that out, it might not matter at all who has the larger one, but we're just trying to make an example of the voltage and the amp hours is really what you should be looking at. And it gets even trickier when the brands jump voltage over their different product lines. So a 4 amp hour on an 18 volt tool does not compare to a 4 amp hour on a 40 volt. The watt hour number is actually going to be telling you the truth on how much energy you're working with. So when you're comparing the batteries, whether it's for e-bikes, power tools, or solar, it's definitely worth looking for the watt hour rating. That watt hour number is telling you the actual amount of energy stored, regardless of the voltage that the system's running with. Thankfully, with solar, everything is usually pretty clear and standard. You'll notice though that a lot of cheap 12 volt batteries are the ones that are messing around with amp hours. And you'll notice it even more so when you get way down to the 3 volt systems. But that's usually with really small power packs. The point here is that amp hours alone is telling you how big the gas tank is, but leaving out whether it's filled with gasoline or jet fuel. Watt hours puts everything on equal footing so you can compare apples to apples. Even with all this said, there is sometimes a situation where amp hours does make more sense. Let's say that you have a camping trailer. You might have all of your appliances in that trailer running on 12 volts. And if you have a 12 volt DC battery system, there's no point in doing the math in watts. Amp hours is all the information that you need. Let's say that you have a 12 volt battery rated at 100 amp hours. And let's just say that you have a high powered fan in your camper that's running theoretically 5 amps. With amp hours, you don't have to do any extra math, you just divide. So 100 amp hours divided by the 5 amps equals 20 hours. That's 20 hours of runtime for that high powered fan. When your whole system runs on the same voltage, amp hours can make battery planning quick and simple. But like most people, when it comes to running a house, anything from a small cabin to a full-sized house on solar, most likely everything in that house is gonna be running on 120 or 240 volts, or at least the plugs that are supplying the power to something like a laptop or a phone, which might be in DC, is still gonna be 120 volts and then converted back to DC. So since right now people aren't using a 120 volt system, watt hours in this case, because of the variety of different appliances and different battery voltages, is the easier way to go. Most appliances will say the wattage on them, but if they don't, the math to figure it out is really easy, just volts times amps. So next time you see a company that has in huge bold print that amp hour number, just take into context the voltage. Now, when you want to get into figuring out how large of a system and watt hours you need, we have other videos that you guys can go and check out that explains how to total up your watts to figure out what your watt hours should be to run your load over a period of time that makes sense for you. So I hope that this cleared stuff up. And if you're a beginner, I know that this information helped me out a lot when I was first starting out building my solar system. Again, as always, if you guys want to help us out, a free way to do that is to subscribe down below. Otherwise, that's all that we got for you guys. Thanks so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.